Hey guys, it's me, Kiki Genkai, Kiki Genshin and Honkai Star Rail. You can call me Kiki. This is my first time using my own voice. I don't have a proper microphone to make a voice over, and honestly I'm not that confident about this, but I'll try my best. Apologies for the voice pitch changing, I'm still learning using the Audacity. Okay, enough of my rambling. And in this video I will only be talking about Isuru Kafka. Since I am a waifu lover, I personally declare that I will be pulling for Kafka. I already found all my resources towards building her, hence if I skip her, it will make me feel like a clown, regardless whether people pay attention or not. Kafka is a DOT amplifier unit, and yes, I realized that she is niche to a DOT team, and I will need to build my sample, Luca and Asta, or any DOT unit that will work with her. Kafka being niche doesn't mean she would be a bad unit, does she? What would her you becoming if they make Kafka multipliers? Low? With kid? Of course, they don't want another zombie episode now, do they? I am not comparing her with a character that is a god in the game's lore. What I meant was Kafka is in a hype train and popular dummy mommy and step on me character. I know that Hoyo would probably pocket tons of money, even when Kafka is a balanced unit. Not too powerful, but also not too far below expectation. Now, what is Kafka doing? I mean, what is her kit revolve around? Most of you probably already found out that many YouTube channels already covered her kit. But for the sake of a complete Kafka general information video, I will get through it with you. Her basic attack, Midnight Tumult, deals lightning damage equal to 50% of Kafka's attack to a single enemy at level 1. And she wouldn't apply shock with her basic attack, and there is no Ascension bonus for it. So it is safe to say you can leave it at level 1, but if you want to max her basic attack then you can go on, but I suggest you prioritize your resources for her ultimate or skill first. Kafka's skill, Caressing Moonlight. The damage is blasted, deals 140% lightning damage of Kafka's attack to a target enemy and 52.5% to enemies adjacent to it. If the target enemy has DOT on them, all DOTs currently placed on that enemy immediately produce damage equal to 71.25% of their original damage on level 8. And this is why we will need Kafka's teammates to be built. In the battle, I need to make sure that Kafka does not overturn my other DOT characters because I want to stack up the DOT, example from Sambo and Luca, first before popping out her ultimate and skill to inflict shock and or triggering the DOT amplifier. But this is still a rough deduction of how I will be running the rotation because I will need to see how the shocks from her talent and her ultimate works, and this is still questionable until I get her home to my account. So everything is not set in stone just yet. Kafka's ultimate, Twilight Trail, deals lightning damage equal to 72% of Kafka's attack to all enemies with 100% base chance to apply shocked for 2 turns and immediately take damage equal to 95% of the DOT from the shock. Talon. After a teammate uses basic attack on an enemy, Kafka immediately launches one follow-up attack to the enemy and deals lightning damage with 100% base chain to inflict shock equivalent to her ultimate for 2 turns. This effect can only trigger 1 time per turn. A reminder here, Kafka applies or inflicts shocks with her techniques, ultimate and her talent or follow-up attack, not her basic attack. Technique. Mercy is not forgiveness. Break toughness by 60. Attack all enemies within a set range. After entering battle, deals AoE lightning damage equal to 50% of Kafka's attack with 100% base chance to inflict shock, equivalent to her ultimate on every enemy target for 2 turns. This is very nice. Very nice technique. After doing my research and I conclude that she will be a fun unit to play with. Now let us go to the pros and cons. Pros. Kafka being the DOT amplifier means that she will age well because she is not purely DPS and her kit revolves around her teammates, all the niche to DOT. By the time she got released, we would find out more of what if she is put in a hyper carry team and how her final mechanic will work. It may sound like copium, but who knows, along the line we will be getting a DOT focused DPS, whether a single target or multiple. Imagine if they released a DPS that works around how much DOT the said character stacked or inflicted to the enemy to dish out any new ultimate or skill damage, or any gimmicks that you could think about with DOT. Next is that Kafka will be easy to build. We will not have to worry about crit ratio, and we could build her as a speedy DOT applier because she could pop out the DOT stack on the enemy without even having to wait for them to take turn. And also, not forgetting that Kafka is a dummy on me and step on me character. The cons. Well, you and me, my friends, who want to pull for Kafka, we will need to build her teammates, their level, traces, their relics and ornaments. Because the DOT damage is higher with a higher leveled character, this makes her an expensive character. In a sense that we will need to earn as many stamina as possible and our resources to get the best team synergy. And to be able to pop out those colorful number on our screen when she triggers her teammate DOT. Kafka's skill wording was, unquote, produce damage equal to X percent of the DOT's original damage, which means it is inherited from her teammate's original DOT damage. Kafka Ascension 2, Torture, making her ultimate to be able to trigger the DOT damage currently on the enemy, just like her skill. Ascension 4, Plunder, even enemy is defeated while sucked, Kafka additionally regenerates 5 energy. Very nice. Ascension 6, Thorns, the best change for ultimate technique or the follow-up attack triggered by the talent to inflict shock increase by 30%. Kafka build, Lightcone. Of course her signature will be the best for her, but if you are after her Eidolons and skipping her Lightcone, then these are the options that are available for you and for me. First, Permata. The Lightcone you can get for free from the MLC shop, and it is better on higher superimposition. I don't have it on S5, and I am not a player that is focused on MOC because I don't have two teams built and are ready to go for the challenge. Since I've been funneling my stamina for Sambo and Kafka, hence why I don't have Butter or Dust to max out the second team's relics. For the 4-star Gacha Lightcone, Good Night Sleep Well, the best 4-star Lightcone that would possibly work for Kafka on max superimposition. The Lightcone description on S5 is, for every debuff the target enemy has, the damage dealt by the wearer is increases by 24%, stacking up to 3 times. This effect also applies to Dark. That is 72% increased damage on 3 stacks, and it sounds amazing for Kafka. Another 4-star gacha option is Eyes of the Prey. The effect rate may be already be too high for Kafka since she only needs a small amount of additional effect hit rate once we maxed out her traces, but this Lightcone is increasing DOT damage by 48% on S5. In the Name of the World on S1, increases the wearer's damage to debuffed enemies by 24%. When the wearer uses their skill, the effect hit rate for this attack increases by 18% and attack increases by 24%. That is already an intriguing stat to put on Kafka. And not to mention, the base stat of 5-star Lightcones are higher. It would be helpful to have more HP and defense from this, so that we could prioritize the relics and ornaments of the stat on attack, break effect, effect hit rate, speed, and effect rest. As for before the tutorial and resolution shines, they are leaning more towards a supportive category, and we could put that on Silver Wove, Sampo, or Pilla, or another Nihility unit that you would like to pair with your Kafka. Don't bother with the 3-star Lightcones, just, you know, they are not good. Relics. 4 pieces of Band of Sizzling Thunder. If you are still finding the main stat for this set, 4 pieces of Musketeer is also nice with its speed that it gave. I'm also still in a dilemma because my Sizzling Thunder set doesn't have enough speed substat on it, but I want to put on an attack boot on my Kafka. You can put on 2 pieces of Sizzling Thunder and 2 pieces of Musketeer if you don't have a 4 pieces set yet. If the enemy is weak to lightning, you could swap her set with 4 pieces of Thief of Soothing Meteor for toughness break her Kafka. And of course, we will be getting our genius theory characters to do their magic to inform us which set or build could pop out the highest number. If anything, farming for Musketeer and Soothing Meteor are still worth it, since if you will encounter enemy that weak on wind or fire, you could put them on your Sampo or Asta. Planar ornaments. This is the most formed planar ornament set on my account, Space Sealing Station. Another ornament set that we could pull on Kafka is Inner Salsato for Kafka personal DPS on ultimate and follow-up attack. Assuming that you have a good roll on your Relics substat that has suffice attack, then elevate Kafka's personal damage with this set will also be viable. Teammates. Nihility slot. Almost everyone in Nihility path is a good pair with Kafka. We have Sampo, Luca, Pella, and Silver Wolf. We could slot triple Nihility team with defensive unit, like Kafka Sampo Silver Wolf or Kafka Sampo Luca or Kafka Sampo Pella. Silver Wolf and Pella could provide a defense red to the enemies, and defense red is also works with DOT damage. And it seems like Sampo is a mandatory unit to be paired with Kafka. He provides a DOT damage increase with his ultimate, and he also could shred enemies' toughness bar, and to be the wielder of Soothing Meteor Relics and Fleet of the Ageless Ornaments. Harmony slot. They are usually the ones with the supportive Relics, Ornaments, and Lightcone. On the top of my list, I would recommend Asta to be the Harmony unit on Kafka's team. She could buff speed, attack, and her toughness bar breaking efficiency is just absolutely fire. Not only because of that, she would be the skill point generator for the team, and she was also able to inflict burns on the enemies with her basic attack. Next up, the one and only Baronia. I mean Baronia Ran. She could help advance the teammate's turn and give an attack buff. The ability to advance forward is proven to be handy in any team comp, but we will have to manage that skill point usage if Bronya is on the team. In the overworld, this shouldn't be a problem at all, but in MOT, this will be another case. Lastly, Tingyun. If I'm facing a lightning weak boss, I would gladly put her on the team with Kafka. Hence this Tingyun will be a conditional unit. Hey, everything is conditional. The main issue with my Tingyun is probably because this Tingyun is still the imposter Tingyun, hence why she really loves getting hit. Her function beauty is over the top that she aggro almost everything towards her. Defensive unit. Jepar, with Train of the Universal Lightcone to inflict burn, or an abundance unit such as Bailu for when the enemy is weak to lightning and pairs with Tingyun, and any other abundance character will do. I personally really want Jepar to be on my team, but sadly I don't have him. And that is guys for now, thank you if you made it this far. This information could change at any moment. Wait until Kafka's official release to get another update, and I will follow up any update too after her release. I hope you find this video informative. Good luck with your pull and play your Kafka, stay hydrated, and see you around. Peace.